Hello everyone. Today, I am going to describe about the red reflex of the eye and its clinical applications. The red reflex test is probably the most important tool in the armamentarium of a pediatrician or an ophthalmologist for detecting amblyopia risk factors in children, especially in the preschool age. This presentation covers the following aspects of the red reflex. As to what is the red reflex and why do we see it? How to acquire this red reflex in clinic, how to differentiate an abnormal red reflex from a normal one, and finally, how to apply it for large-scale screening for amblyopia risk factors. The red reflex is the reflection of light from the back of the eye. Now, since the retinochoroidal complex is red in color, due to the abundance of blood vessels, the reflected light from it is also red in color. This red reflex can be seen commonly in animals such as cats and dogs in the night when a headlight of a vehicle shines on their dilated pupils. One might ponder that why this red reflex is not seen in everyone's pupil under normal circumstances. This is because the optical system of the eye is such that all the reflected light from the retinochoroidal complex, which is illuminated from a source of light, travels back and is focused onto the source of light itself. Thus, an observer who is observing from a different angle observes a dark portion of the retina rather than the illuminated portion. Until and unless the source of light and the observer are optically aligned, it is impossible to capture the reflected light from the subject's retina. Thus, the pupil appears dark. This problem was overcome by the inventors of the direct ophthalmoscope. In this device, the light is projected onto the examinee's eye after reflection from a semi-reflective mirror or a mirror with hole or a partial mirror or prism, thereby enabling a part of the reflected light to reach the observer's eye, thus capturing the red reflex and even enabling examination of the fundus. The technique of acquiring a red reflex using a direct ophthalmoscope is a simple one. One needs a dark or a semi-dark room. The pupils of the patient may or may not be pharmacologically dilated. The child should be comfortable and look towards the light of the direct ophthalmoscope at least for a few seconds. The ideal distance for performing this is around half a meter. The light from the ophthalmoscope is shown on both the eyes together and the quality of the red reflex obtained is compared between the two eyes. While this technique was first described using a direct ophthalmoscope, do not get disheartened if you do not have it. In today's world, it can be easily captured by a simple camera or more conveniently a smartphone. Several of the photographs shown in this presentation are acquired using a smartphone. One has to make sure that the flash is on and the red eye reduction mode is off while using the smartphone to capture a red reflex. Also, the reflex is captured better if the pupils are dilated. The smartphones have been appreciated because of their ability to capture the red reflex and detect eye cancers. These two photographs show the appearance of a normal red reflex, the upper one with dilated pupils and the lower one with undilated pupils. It can be noted that a normal red reflex is symmetric, homogeneous, and illuminates the entire pupil uniformly. An abnormal red reflex can be categorized into three types: a dull or an absent reflex, a white reflex, or a non-uniform or asymmetric reflex. A dull or absent reflex signifies that either the light is unable to reach the patient's retina or unable to come out of the patient's eye. This can happen with media opacities like cataract, corneal scars, vitritis, or vitreous opacities. It can happen with non-dilating pupils due to posterior synechiae or shallow retinal detachments. The dull reflex due to a partial cataract can be used to monitor progression, especially in young children, as used in this child with galactosemic cataract. The child was advised a galactose-free diet and one can see the reduction of the lenticular opacity over time. Thus, one can avoid examination under anesthesia and also maintain a record of these images captured by the smartphone. A white reflex, on the other hand, is seen due to reflection of light from a totally opacified lens or an abnormal retina. This is the commonest symptom and an important sign of retinoblastoma, which is the most common primary intraocular tumor. It is an alarming situation and warrants urgent referral to a specialist. The reflex in retinoblastoma is often yellowish-white that may differentiate it from the grayish-white reflex from other causes. The other causes are total cataracts, total retinal detachments, and end-stage retinopathy of prematurity. A non-uniform red reflex in one eye often signifies a refractive error. Also, asymmetricity, which means difference between the two eyes, arises due to anisometropia, strabismus, or structural abnormalities of the eye, namely fundal coloboma. In all these situations, the eye with the brighter reflex is often the one with the pathology. An example of a non-uniform reflex is seen in the left eye of the upper photograph. A crescent of bright light is seen in the inferior half of the pupil. Also, both the upper and the lower photographs show asymmetricity. The right eye in the upper one has a bright uniform reflex and an almond shape of the pupil suggesting uveal coloboma. Compare this with the uniform homogeneous red reflex in the right eye of the lower photograph, which is a normal red reflex. The left eye in the lower photograph again has a uniform bright reflex, but this one is due to inward deviation of that eye. Thus, the red reflex test can easily detect the presence of strabismus and refractive errors, both of which are the most common cause of amblyopia risk factors in children. One would wonder whether the type of refractive error may be predicted by the red reflex. Yes, it can. As you can see in the following photographs, the location of the crescents in the pupil depends on the type of refractive error. For most smartphones, the location of the flash of the light is such that the superior crescent is formed in myopia and the inferior crescent is formed in hyperopia. Of course, a difference in the size of the crescents signifies anisometropia, the larger crescent forming in the eye with higher refractive error. By now, one must have realized the importance of the red reflex test by virtue of the enormous amount of information that can be obtained from it. For the same reason, it has been recommended by various pediatric ophthalmology academic societies as the screening tool for children up to 5 years of age. A child's eye problems are often missed as they do not complain. They may go unnoticed if they are unilateral. There is a lack of universal screening policy for preschool children in most countries and even no mandatory screening before school entry. While some developed countries have screening recommendations for preschool age, there are none for infants and toddlers. In India, the screening programs are limited to school-going children between 10 to 15 years of age. A lot of amblyopia is missed during the period that is the most responsive to treatment. There is a need for more targeted screening in younger ages, like integration with school admissions and with vaccination. However, till that is achieved, the onus for early detection lies with pediatricians and ophthalmologists. If one does not want to interpret the results of the red reflex themselves, one could use photo screeners. These are devices that automatically interpret the red reflex and recommend whether further evaluation is required or not. They are simple, easy to operate, and no dilatation of pupils is required. The child is needed to look towards the device for only a fraction of a second for image acquisition, and a report like this is generated. It is recommended for screening of amblyopia risk factors below 5 years of age. Various photo screeners are available with comparable sensitivities and specificities. The device-based photo screeners are portable machines, some of which can be linked to a web portal for storing the images. Also, a phone-based photo screener, which makes it even more handy with an application that allows storage of images and reanalysis later. We studied the performance of the spot photo screener in preschool children and found the device to have 85% sensitivity and 69% specificity when compared with APO's referral criteria. Other photo screeners have been found to have similar accuracy for screening for amblyopia risk factors. However, I want to emphasize that these devices are recommended just for screening and should not be used to make actual prescription of glasses in children. To conclude, the red reflex test is an important tool for detection of amblyopia risk factors and visual comorbidities in children. A simple direct ophthalmoscope or a smartphone can be used to acquire them. Photo screeners can make it less user-dependent and can thus be used in screening programs. And in the current situation, it is one test that respects social distancing. These are some suggested sources of information, and thank you for your patient listening.